and Kulin Nation and their relationship with the land. My name is Gilbert, and I'm the president of the Alliance Française de Melbourne. The Alliance Française is an Australian not-for-profit organisation dedicated to the promotion of French language teaching and culture. It was founded in 1890 and is the oldest in Australia and one of the oldest in the world. Welcome to Gestuelles, the art of transmission by Aboriginal desert women, curated by the International Development for Australian Indigenous Art in partnership with the Embassy of France and the Alliance Française de Melbourne. The Alliance Française has very close links with Aboriginal art. It has been collaborating with the East Gippsland Aboriginal Arts Corporation and the Port Phillip Council for the last 5 years, exhibiting Aboriginal art as part of the Yalukit Willem Nagari Arts and Cultural Festival. It is a great pleasure and honour for the Alliance Française to host Gestuelles here tonight. This exhibition celebrates France's participation in the development and recognition of Australian Indigenous art and the role of Aboriginal women artists. It explores women's painting and their gestures relating to transmission from younger emerging artists to senior painters. I will leave the experts to elaborate further about the exhibition. It's my pleasure now to introduce to you Auntie Carolyn Briggs, an elder from the Yalukit Willem Bunwaran language group, who is recognized as a keeper of the history and genealogies of a people. Auntie Carolyn has been active in community development, native title, cultural preservation and cultural promotion. For many years, she ran the Janani restaurant in Melbourne, which specialised in contemporary Aboriginal cooking, fine dining, promoted the Bunwaran culture and language, and became the place to meet for Indigenous people. Auntie Carolyn established Australia's first Aboriginal childcare centre and is chair of the Bunwaran Foundation, which she set up to connect Aboriginal youth to their heritage. Auntie Carolyn is also a member of the National Congress of Australia's First Peoples. Please welcome Auntie Carolyn.
So Womanjika, Marambik, Bunurong, Nundurp, Barup and Antawillow. And that means welcome to our beautiful home, the land of the Great Bay. To our guests. Yes. I've just got to get that right.
I don't want to see a part, I'll just forget it.
And to yours guests. As a descendant of Melbourne's First People, I'm pleased to be able to share this special occasion with you and also share the pride of our heritage. Before the Europeans arrived at this part of Australia, it was the traditional country and homeland of the Kulin Nation. The Kulin Nation consisted of five major language groups: the Bunwaran, the Woiwurrung, the Wadawurrung, the Jarawurrung, and the Tanwurrung. And that's about the diversity of our landscape and how you speak your country. It's not, you know, we have, and it means Warang is your tongue. And your way you speak your language is the diversity of what your language and your land has to offer you to be able to speak your country. My great-grandmother was from the Yalukit Willem of the Bunwaran clan. She was born in the 1830s at the same time as the Europeans established their settlement here in Melbourne. And as our custom, I'd like to share a short story with you as a way of welcoming you to this beautiful city of Port Phillip. When my great-grandmother was a young girl, with the arrival of the Europeans, a time of great change began for our people. When the Europeans first arrived in Melbourne, they were treated as guests, as was the custom of our people. But these guests, unlike other visitors, did not leave. Not only did these visitors not leave, they also broke our laws. They killed their animals and did not eat their flesh. They killed the fish during their breeding season. The animals trampled across our yam gardens. They blocked our rivers and creeks. The people became frightened and sought the advice of their old wise men and women. The old people retreated and considered their fears. Then they returned and called their people together. The old wise men and women explained that they seen a vision, and in this vision they saw a period where there would be much upheaval and despair. It's just not like any other country around the world, where people have come from different places to establish their settlements here in Melbourne. But the old wise men and women said that they'd seen a second vision, and in this vision they saw a new world, where the strength and the power of the people of the Bornwurrung and the Kulin nation would again be strong. They saw a time when the rivers would run clear, a time when the animals would be protected according to the laws of Bunjil. They saw a time when the heritage and the culture of the Kulin nation would again be celebrated. Today our traditional country now consists of a great multicultural city where people, arts, culture, sports are celebrated. Melbourne also hosts one of the most vibrant expressions of modern Indigenous culture and heritage through music, art and drama. You will see our art in the galleries. You will see our sportsmen and women on the fields. You will see our performers both on stage and in film. As someone who's been actively involved in the well-being of our communities, but also the tourism industry, I feel a great pride when visitors feel honoured to be able to share Melbourne's rich Indigenous heritage. Today is my hope that we can all take pride in our shared history and celebrate the strength of this great state and city. It is about this great state of Victoria. It's also my hope that the descendants of the first people can share in these benefits. According to our traditions, our lands will always be protected by our creator, Bunjil, who travels as an eagle, and by Wan, who protects our waterways, travels as a crow. Bunjil taught us to always welcome guests, but he required us to ask all visitors to make two promises. One, not to harm the land of Bunjil, and not harm its children of Bunjil. And this commitment is made through exchange of a small vow dipped in the water of the land. So it is about those connections. It's not just in isolation as me standing here. I'm a part of a bigger picture. And like Gestuelles, the art of transmission by the Aboriginal desert women, it challenges the Western societies haven't learned to see yet, and learn to see the land for what it is. Women have developed a unique expression through these meetings and canvases, the familiar mix of country and family in these landscapes. The diversity in these landscapes is uniquely different. The portrayal of connection. And it's about non-verbal communication. So it is about learning to open, and what we talk about is the deep listening. When we're talking to each other and sharing knowledge, sometimes it is about that connection and that deep listening. but it's also about learning to see. And looking at how these people have, these women have depicted using these materials in modern concepts, it's telling how they see their lands and how they connect to those lands. It's different from the maps that you may see. But it is about uniquely those connections, and it's all about those familiar connections. And those are the connections we have with you. So it is that vision of learning to see this beautiful expression of this the art. So Womajika, Murrumbeke, Bunurong, Namda, Barup and Umpawurrung, we celebrate and we showcase the diversities of these images that will continue to help us connect to each other. And in Western society, it is about questioning, not transferring. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Auntie Caroline, for your work.